Barracuda is a novel about a young man, Danny Kelly, who has a dream to be one of the great Olympic swimmers. When we first start the novel, he's a 14-year-old from a very working... He's a working-class kid who has got a scholarship to a very elite school because of his phenomenal talent as a swimmer. But that dream fails. He doesn't become a success. And that cost of that failure, the shame of that failure, the suffering of that failure is what I wanted to explore in the novel. I should also say that when we begin with a 14-year-old Danny, but we also have an alternative beginning, which is with the same man in his early 30s, because I wanted to be very clear from the outset to the reader that this young man never achieved his dream. So you know from the beginning that it's another kind of story. And really for me, I'll put it most simply, when I began writing this book, I had one card above my desk and it said, this is a story of how to be a good man. And that's what I wanted the book to be. Because I knew that Danny's dream was going to fail from the outset, and because I knew I wanted the reader to understand that, I wanted to think about a structure that would allow me to make that clear from the outset. And I actually borrowed, or stole, or whatever we do as writers, and I borrowed from cinema, I actually borrowed from the notion of the jump cut. The notion that you can actually flash forward and you can flash back. So I developed a structure where we had alternating chapters, short chapters in the first person, which started as with Danny, 34 years old, going back to childhood, and then much longer chapters in between in the third person, which was Danny as a 14-year-old going to adulthood. And what that gave me was the freedom to move in between time, and also in a certain way a freedom to trust the reader that there were there were elements of Danny's story that I didn't have to explicate. Let me give you a concrete example, right? I knew right from the outset that Danny was going to be gay. Like, I just knew it because I heard a voice, and I heard this young, angry 14-year-old voice. I knew something about who he was going to be. But I didn't want to write the coming out story because I felt that wasn't... The real story is about shame. The real story is about how you deal with shame and you come back from shame, how you make atonement for shame. So I thought, how do I use that structure to propel the story and to propel it in what is important? And what I mean about trust is that you as a reader, you don't need to have that moment where Danny comes out to his mother and father. You don't need that moment when he comes out to his brother and his sister and his friends. You can fill that in. Barracuda for me is a novel about belonging, which is a particular question for a lot of us who are Australians who are not from an Aboriginal background. Like, that sense of, this is a country we love, but this is also a country that may not belong to us. We are from elsewhere. And that's certainly part of what animates Danny. I think that is one of the central themes of it, but it's also a novel about class. And even though I am an educated, very fortunate man, and now I'm no longer working class. I can't call myself that because of the life I live and the experiences I've had. The one connection I have with that is that I do come from that world. That's my parents' world. That's a world I understand. The success of The Slap, in a way, made that even more pronounced for me because I realised what it does mean to have money, and it does, you know, that is an incredible fortune to be able to say that. So I came to this novel wanting to write about class, and thinking about writing about class also made me want to ask, what is the language you use to write about that experience? The fact that English is my language. English is the language I grew up with. English is the language I use. English is the language I was educated in. But my first language is actually Greek. And there is... And I only discovered this through the process, I think, of writing this novel, that there is a musicality to Greek that I wanted to incorporate into the English language. So in a way, I'm a creation of a hybrid culture. I wanted to create a hybrid language as well. And a great love of music. I mean, when I think of writing, I think in musical terms. I went back for the first time, in some instances, for the first time in years, to some of the novels that I fell in love with as an adolescent and as a young man. And they were the Russian novels, they were Dickens, they were, they were the classic narrative story. And I realised that actually that is important to me as the kind of writer I want to be. That I'm not going to be the postmodern writer, I'm not going to be necessarily the self-reflective writer. I'm not going to be the avant-garde writer. That I love those novels. I love the experimental novel. I love the that kind of writing. But we have... but we're not all capable of that. And I'm not capable of that. What I am capable of, I hope, is being able to tell a propulsive narrative and a propulsive story about human life. That's what I think I learned from Barracuda.